Hey, Pearls and Prosecco here. I have two Goodwill blue boxes, or a blue box and a blue bag, to open for you today. So last week when I looked at the Goodwill blue boxes, and if you don't know what those are, Goodwill once a week on Fridays at I believe 6 o'clock Eastern Standard Time puts boxes of all different kinds of things on their website, and they usually sell out really, really fast, like 30 seconds or less fast. So this one was a new one. This is one supposed to be a designer handbag. So I thought I would open this before I do my jewelry Goodwill blue bag. So, or blue box. I guess we should call this the Goodwill blue bag. So it did say that these can be, please cut here so you can reuse. This package is all about reusing. Okay. It did say that these can be a little in need of. A Dooney Burke. Wow. The corners have a tiny bit of wear on them, and it's really just those corners. Oh, I'm impressed. Mystery purse from Blue Box. We believe that clothing and purses should be worn, not wasted. Your purchase supports our nonprofit programs and helps us reduce textile waste in our community. We hope you enjoy the purse that our team has curated just for you. Well, yeah, I have no problems with this purse. Thank you, Goodwill Blue Box. There's no stains. The handle's good. The inside is clean. I mean, it's like, it almost has that feel like somebody has just worn it in perfectly for me. And it's big enough for my MacBook. So yes, I am happy, 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 happy about this. And I had decided if I really liked it, I was gonna keep it. And if I didn't really like it, I was gonna sell it. So just to give you an idea, this was $19.99. And it was $4.99 shipping because I got two blue boxes on that day. So $24.98 for a really nice Dooney Burke. I'm happy with that. All right. I'm having a hard time moving on from that. All right. Let me get this out of the way. Put my receipts in my receipt pile. And this is a nice bag that can be used again and again and again. So stick him over with my packing material, and I promise I will be right back. Alright, so it's a heavy hammer jamma. Alright, so this is my jewelry blue box. So these are $29.99 plus shipping, and I think my shipping was maybe $4.99 for this. We will see when we open it. And I'm just going to tell you right now, I doubt I will get through this whole thing in one video. But we'll get as far as we can. I guess I should have opened it before. I also have two other boxes. One that got kind of lost, we've been looking for a couple weeks. And another one that I ordered recently. Ooh, there's some pretty stuff in here. Ooh, I guess I should let you look. There's some nice stuff in here. I don't know if there's any precious metals, but this is definitely different than the last box I got. The last box I got was like a ton of bracelets and broken earrings. All right, yes, so it's $29.99. Oh, and this one was the $7.99 shipping. So I guess the purses, the shipping is a little bit cheaper on. So I'm just going to kind of put him this way. and just start to pull some stuff out, and we'll see what we see. So this little guy fell out first. He just looks like a little gold ball. Not sure about him. Just put him over to the side. Anything that I end up not keeping, like this is probably a good example. If I can get him untangled. So this is a little wire memory bracelet that is so tangled on something. Oh, come on. Okay. Cute little wire memory bracelet. Nice little cat's eye beads, little flower beads. He's really cute, but I am not going to be able to make enough of a profit on this guy for me to just sell him by himself. So he is going to go into what I call a craft lot. So a craft lot is not necessarily all broken jewelry, but it's jewelry that I am not selling. It might be broken. It might be totally wearable. It might be sellable. This is really pretty. But I usually sell it by the pound, usually in 5-pound lots for about $20. Why did I not bring my glasses down? Why? This is bar with a dove. Never heard of that. And I certainly do not think that he is. I don't think that he is gold. I mean, he's definitely kind of a, but he's very pretty. Very, very, very pretty. I'm gonna have to, oh, yeah, there's a little place that he's kind of, nope, that's how he's made. Never mind. The little rhinestones are kind of loose. He's really pretty. I'll have to look up. I'm sure that you can't see that. There's no possible way that you could see that. There's nothing I can really do so that you can see it. But he's really pretty. I think he'll clean up. Let's see. Just kind of. Oh, yeah. He's going to clean up and be sparkly and really pretty. So he's definitely going in a sell pile. So those are items that I will clean up, take pictures of, and I will list in my, probably my Mercari store. I got off of Poshmark while I tried to figure out this tangle. I just wasn't getting a lot of attention there, and what I was getting, people wanted stuff for super, super cheap, and I wasn't making any money. So I left there. This is a lucky cuff. It's got that kind of hammered look. Ooh, and he is definitely a small, but hey, that kind of looks cool. So, you know, if he will clean up, he's not too badly scratched. If he will clean up, that will go in a sell pile and bring a few dollars. Let's see what we got here. A set of earrings. These are interesting earrings. I don't know if you can see these. It's kind of a bluish stone. And these are rhinestones. They're interesting. But I don't see any marks. No maker marks. So more than likely, these will go into a craft lot. Sometimes I sell just earring craft lots. People seem to really like those. This is just a cheapy bangle. He's going in a craft lot. Or he just fell out of the craft lot, actually. We'll hold him and see if we find his partner. Stuff is really tangled. All right, so this is a fairly old rhinestone piece. Let's see if I can lay it out, if you can see it. Better if I lay it out. Of course, that really helps. Which way, which way? Yeah, I'm not very good at cameras, guys. I'm just gonna tell you. All right, look at this guy. So he's silver tone and he's a little grimy, but I like the way he lays. I like this. See, I keep pulling it back till you see it. I like that. And he's definitely older, has a vintage clasp, no markings. I'm gonna hold on to him though. I really like him. Gonna hold on to him. I know there's somebody out there who just really loves that kind of stuff. All right, so this is definitely an older shell. It's a shell necklace, and you can see where the shells have been dyed kind of this corally red, and the color is coming off of them. So I don't know. Do you guys sell shell necklaces? I think I'm gonna put him in my craft lock. Simply, some of this stuff I could sell, but I literally have two huge boxes of stuff that I need to list. So I can be a little more picky. Okay, so this guy's interesting. Look at this guy. If I can get him. Look at that. He's pretty cool. And then it's just silver beads. And this kind of gold, I mean, almost looks like somebody made him, because this clasp definitely does not fit with the rest of the necklace. He's so unique, although, see, he's got all his stones. He's very unique. And there is a maker's mark. Oh, he's Avon. I'm gonna look this up because I kind of, he could be all Avon or he could have been on a necklace. But these, I forget what you call these, cylinder beads are very Avon. They're very Avon style. For those of you who don't know, I also work for Avon. But the paint is actually wearing off a little bit. So I'm gonna keep him and look because there are definitely people who love Avon. I'm going to put that earring over to the side. This is just a little stretchy faceted bead necklace. So he's an example of something that will go in a craft lot. And so is this one. This looks like it was maybe a necklace on a string with these little itty bitty pieces. So those will go in a craft lot. And then let's look at this brooch. I do not see a maker's mark. He looks fairly old, but not super, super old. Maybe 90s, 80s. See if we can get the light to catch. They're purple stones in a silver tone, but it's got a. I gotta work on this camera angle. He's really pretty. I'm gonna keep him. And hold on a sec, guys. So sorry. Let me change that. All right, so this guy is interesting. He's kind of interesting. He's all little clear beads that are plastic. And I would say that it's old, but it is gunmetal, and gunmetal is not that old of a metal. And there's no maker's mark. So he is going to go in a craft lot and make someone super, super happy. They're gonna make something super cool with him. All right. If this is Avon, I'm gonna die because it looks so Avon. Let's see. It's got a mark that I can't read. Oh, it's Jafari. And that's patent pending, is the mark I can't read. It is a Jafari. Jafari gold tone necklace, and it's got, oh, it's missing a stone. Do you know I have so much Jafari jewelry that is missing a stone? I wonder if I could do a Jafari lot of jewelry that are all missing one stone. So that's definitely choker length. I should do a Jafari. I'm gonna put him over to the side by himself. I'm seriously thinking about doing a Jafari a lot of Jafari. Okay, how many times can I say Jafari? Of Jafari jewelry that's missing a stone. So this is just a little faux leather bracelet with a little polymer bead. So he's going in a craft lot. Oh, this is interesting. Oh, he's missing stones too. And I bet he's Jafari. He looks just like the other. Maybe somebody who's really crafty could take some of the stones from this one and put it in the other one. He does not say Jafari, and actually the metal isn't quite the same. Oh, no, he's Jafari. He's also Jafari. He's missing a lot of these little rhinestones right here. But still, very, very cool looking. So we're going to make a Jafari. I know I'm not saying that right. Jafari. I'm going to make a lot of it that's all missing a stone and see if that sells to anybody. All right, so this is an interesting little bracelet, and it's a VCLM, whatever that may be. All these different little chains. Kind of cool. Not really in good shape, though, so he's going to go in a craft lot. This little boot just stuck out to me. And there's a whale tail, and there's all kinds of stuff. It is so tangled. I may have to pull out the tangled stuff and sort it later. Let's see what we can get out. Oh, this is an interesting bracelet. Glass beads. That's glass. Kind of looks like a stone, but it's definitely glass. And it's one that you twist up and make it tighter. He's kind of interesting. I'm going to put him in my keep pile for now. Who knows what I'll do with him. Oh, now this is pretty. And he does have a maker's mark also. Silver. Silver is the maker's mark. Let's see if there's a maker's mark on this side. No. So if silver is the maker's mark, does that mean that it is silver? So these look like, kind of look like little freshwater pearls. And it's a fairly long necklace. And then it's got a box clasp that has a pearl on it. And it says silver. Hmm. He is in very good condition. Oh, there's one little spot. I think he can be cleaned up. So I am gonna have to put him over in my pile to investigate also. I'll have to see what he is. Oh, that's an interesting brooch. No maker's mark. And he's it's almost like somebody put washi tape or vinyl or something on the top. I have no idea. He is gonna go. He's a very cool brooch. Somebody could really do something really cool on the front of this. So, ooh, just stuck myself with him. So he's gonna go in a craft lot. He will make someone super happy, I am sure. All right, what else is in here? Okay, so these are just black plastic beads. Craft lot. And this is a plastic bangle. Craft lot. Like, neither of the bangles actually went into the craft lot. That's just awesome. All right. Oh, this is neat. It's a pendant and it's shell. Look at that. Oh, it's cracked. Ah. Oh, it was so cool looking. Oh, crack, go away. How cool is that? Okay, he's going in the craft lot. Hopefully someone can fix him up and make him look nice. And what is this? A coin grid. Oh, Green Dots Bank. So this is like a Harry Potter coin. Green Dots Bank? Maybe? Grid Guts? I'm not sure. Okay. I will talk to my Harry Potter, my resident Harry Potter fan about that one. Oh, this was so cute, and it probably broke in the box. It was a reindeer pin. Oh, how sad it broke. All right, I will have to put him in a craft lot. Ooh, finding a couple oohs. Let's see, somehow this opens. I can get him off. This is an interesting bracelet. It is a small, God love me, I'm never gonna get it back off. Look at that inlaid with, I have never seen rhinestones cut the way these are cut. They are so brilliant. It's almost like they're channel cut. But the metal is in very, very, very bad condition. Why don't they invent something that you can, like, we can rub over metal when it's kind of like worn out? We can rub over it and bring it back to life. I wish, because he's so, so pretty. All right, he's going in a craft lot. He would be pretty for someone who figures out how to do that. All right. Here's another one of these bracelets. They are plastic. For a second, I thought they weren't. Oh, now this is dirty as I'll get out, but it is black rhinestones. Black rhinestones. It is really, really dirty. I'm wondering if I clean it up though, if it would sell. All right, I'm gonna put him over in my experiment pile. So I'm gonna do a few more, and then I'm probably gonna cut to a new video for the rest of this, because it is getting kind of long. Okay, so this is a stretchy. It actually has pretty good stretch, and it has, my neighbor's outside like, what are you doing? It's got these little like people, and then I guess that's like a snake. And that's like another people. So I do a lot of boho and tribal lots. So that would go great in there. And let's see if I can do one more before I switch. All right, so this one's kind of cool. Kind of beads, they're all plastic, but it's still really pretty. So maybe I can do a stretch bracelet something and put that one in. Okay, so I am going to stop this video so that you don't get bored out of your mind. And then I'm gonna pick up on a new video. And if you come join me again, you'll see the rest of this crazy, crazy lot. I am gonna untangle some of this stuff before I start the next one. So I will see you again soon. Bye guys.